Ultimately, it would give Blue Mages a reason to go the fuck home and stop ultra-vibrating all over my leveling fate, you fucking strangled smut. How's it going, Royals Alike? I'm Miff, the LVL may or may not be an escaped retainer. Don't look at me like that, I'm a bastard, not a bank. And today I wanted to talk a little bit about what we might reasonably expect from Beastmasters and Blue Mages in the upcoming expansion. Now, it's no secret that the recent yokai event had me finally sliding into the Blue Mages DMs like a middle-aged katana wielder on Tinder, and as a man of culture who doesn't skip fucking quest text, you heathens, I was able to piece together enough background lore to open my eyes wider than a Doctor Who tired as fuck up, leading to him arriving at Hiroshima on August 6th. 1945. First off though, as we're about to dive into lore, speculation and prediction, you've no doubt already turned to your partner like, don't worry honey, it'll all be over soon. Joke's on you motherfucker, I wear my socks and a tool belt during sex, I always come prepared. I've decided to deploy Floki again to ensure complete compliance, but hey, thought why not take this time to introduce his daughter, your staller. Try leaving now, I fucking dare you. Side note, yes, she's not bald, her mother is a Bengal. Here, take a look, this is Lagafet. She's an asshole too. Surprise Myth Catlaw! So where do I get the nerve to have such a clickbait title on YouTube of all places you ask, from your suitably high horse? Well that's easy. You see, we learned from our blue bro Martin that his esoteric school of magic was introduced to him by the Walaki, a tribe of the New World. That's right, our upcoming beach holiday Dawntrail also sees us visiting the home of blue magic. To Roll, known to the people of Eorzea as the New World, is a continent located far to the west of the three great continents, across the ocean of the Indigo Deep. Now we know the Walaki live somewhere in Tyrol, though it is not known precisely where. They make their home near an area called Lapis Canyon that is rich in cerulean. Those who have played Blue Mage so far will understand that the Walaki hold the colour blue as sacred because Lapis Canyon glows blue with cerulean. You know it better as the fuel the Galleons have coveted until they were inevitably folded like a tea towel, or better still, towards the end of the Blue Mage 1.0, where we had to stop Bungus McChungus from stealing it after he forced the Walaki to sell him mining rights to the canyon in exchange for a cure or a deadly virus the Eorzeans accidentally brought to the New World. Now, our experience up to this point has saw the limited job level cap be dragged behind the current expansion like an unwanted or least favourite child. Even now, with a current cap of 90, the Blue Mage is stuck at 80, looking upon the lands of Izabard and the Northern Empty with an envious plagiaristic grin, waiting for its moment to plunder, copy and steal shit from his locals. Man, when you think of it that way, Blue Mage really is a metaphor for the British Empire. Colonize everything! But I digress. In any other situation, I would say prepare for another 10 levels, serving as an excuse to engage with the shared fate system. However, like self-love of a dead arm, this feels slightly different. Yoshi P has promised us this is an expansion with more content dense than any before. And when speculating on what that is and where it could appear, is it really too bold a prediction to suggest that the Blue Mages will not be waiting until 8.0 to see and engage with their home? And is it bolder still to suggest you should subscribe to this incredibly British Lalafell on his journey to 1,000 subscribers? We're heading to the tippy top to colonize Jesus. Grab your tea and join me, good sir! Dawntrail is serving as a revamp for a lot of fan favorite content, with promises made to update various aspects of the game's current formula, with hunts, open world content, deep dungeons, smaller party content, solo content, and reward systems all being mentioned on a sexy little coming up list that makes me wetter than a cinema seat cushion at a magic mic screen. Limited jobs will make a very natural addition to this list and have been thus far only briefly addressed with the announcement of Beastmaster, an entirely new limited job officially confirmed to cure Blue Mage loneliness, coming in the later patches. What if the silence here is the most telling thing? We know from observation alone, now enforced by the recent yokai event, that the content Blue Mages are currently mainly used for is the aforementioned shared fate system. For those that don't know, shared fates track the number of fates you've completed in the regions of Shadowbringers and Endwalker. When you increase your rank within a zone, you unlock new unique items which can be purchased using the unique currency by the Coiled Gemstone. What better way to revive interest and prepare players for the 7 to 8.0 content drop than dropping an additional limited job with a mostly reworked system of engagement and 20 extra levels for our bestiality bros and buddies in blue? Coincidentally, this could also be the point at which much needed tweaks to the fate system are put in place that could very much fall under the open world content bracket, though that could be its own video. Ultimately, it would give Blue Mages a reason to go the fuck home and stop ultra vibrating all over my leveling fate, you fucking strangled smut. Anyways, I've waffled on enough. What do you think? Let me know in the comments down below. Smash that subscribe button as we creep ever closer to the 1000 milestone and click this, because no one can convince me that the YouTube algorithm isn't just Skynet with extra steps and it's in charge of my recommendations right now. Don't make it angry.